Magnificence, ladies and gentlemen, dear friends and colleagues, welcome to the Human Brain Project public event eBrains. This event takes place in order to introduce a new infrastructure for brain research here in Heidelberg. Why an infrastructure? The human brain is one of the most complex systems that we know. And in order to understand the human brain, we do not need only empirical research, but also theory, and we need a strong infrastructure supporting data analytics, modeling and simulation. And of course, we have to take into consideration from the very beginning that ethics and society play a central role in this endeavor. So where we are in the Human Brain Project? We are now in the so-called SGA2 phase, that is a little bit more than 3 years before the project officially is finished. And in this phase, last phase, we would like to build a European infrastructure that is sustainable. So we plan to submit a proposal to the European Commission to go to the so-called S3 roadmap in order to provide the tools and services that we are developing and have developed during the last year on a longer term to the European science community. And in this last phase of the project, we would like to focus on computing the brain to make this possible. That means we are addressing the human multiscale brain connectome and its variability, and would like to better understand what are the networks for cognition and consciousness, and apply this knowledge also to better understand adaptive architecture of networks of cognitive function, and to build and provide access to the eBrains infrastructure. Today, on the 25th of November, we are launching eBrains publicly in Heidelberg in order to reach out to a larger community of users of this eBrains infrastructure. What can you expect from this day? Our infrastructure operations director, Jan Bialy, will introduce the concept of eBrains as a platform for collaboration in digital neuroscience. And he will provide some examples of how this platform enables, for example, provenance tracking of data and allows to follow up the acquisition of data up to the publication of data in a very transparent and very reproducible way. And this effort is connected to other efforts that we have in Europe, for example, regarding EOSC. Petra Ritter from the Charité in Berlin will introduce the virtual brain. The virtual brain is a tool that allows to develop models of the human brain, not only in health, but also in disease. So the virtual brain includes models of brains of patients with epilepsy, stroke, tumors, and Alzheimer's disease, for example. And it allows to develop individualized models. Why it is so important? Because at the end, we want to create a benefit for individual patients. And the HBP is very proud that this summer, a large clinical trial started in France with about 400 participants undergoing surgery for epilepsy, and the virtual brain will be tested in this very concrete clinical environment. Rüdiger Dillmann will give an introduction to neurobotics and how we can use basic neuroscience knowledge, for example, from how we control movements to neurobotics applications, and will present recent results, for example, on how control pointing motion is implemented with spiking neural networks, a technique that we are developing in neuromorphic computing. Dirk Pleiter from the Research Center Jülich will introduce a federated high-performance computing infrastructure which enables cloud and storage services for researchers in whole Europe. So this is the e-infrastructure which includes workflows running on high-performance computing, and it brings high-performance computing to the exascale range for neuroscientists. ECAI is a funding mechanism that allows access to the interactive computing infrastructure provided by Phoenix. And here is a very concrete example how already now this network works. It comes from a collaboration of Jülich and Zurich scientists running workflows on two different sites in two different countries. And of course, such workflows can be then transferred to other high-performance computing centers, and our aim is to acquire these centers according to the needs of a certain process that has to be computed in the Human Brain Project. One of the components that we would like to more and more closely integrate into this Phoenix infrastructure are neuromorphic computing. And the HPP is very proud of having two most advanced neuromorphic computing systems in the project from the very beginning. These are Spinnaker and BrainSkills here from Heidelberg. Steve Ferber will illustrate what the advances in neuromorphic computing technology are and show, for example, that simulations of a cortical column here done on a Spinnaker base are for certain workflows faster than on classical supercomputing. And we think that learning from the brain, for example, how plasticity and learning are being implemented in natural networks also helps us to further develop neuromorphic devices. In the last talk of the day, Lars Klüber will give an overview about the societal relations, neuroethics, and community building. We observe that approaches such as artificial neuronal networks and AI are dynamically evolving, and they complement existing tools for researching complex systems. This opens, of course, new perspectives in medicine, for example, for therapy, diagnostic, and prediction, but also neuroenhancement and related ethical questions. Insight from brain research, for example, concerning plasticity, continuous learning, architecture of networks, inspire new technology in neuromorphic computing, robotics, and other fields. But in order to make this possible, we have to make sure that the algorithms, therefore, are transparent and they are verifiable. And the degree to which it's successful has consequences for issues such as safety, security, responsibility, but also liability. So the evolution of systems processing information has to be accompanied from the very beginning by ethical reflection. And we see that the demands on users and researchers are constantly growing. This creates an educational mission and also requires new strategy for outreach. All these topics will be addressed in this event today. And I wish you a nice and fruitful day here in Heidelberg with many new insights and many new ideas. Thank you very much.